हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन ट्यूटोरियल क्लासेस फॉर विद्या भवन हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल. आई एम टीचिंग यू न्यूट्रिशन एंड दिस वीडियो इज अकॉर्डिंग टू द इन्फेंसी एंड द वीडियो नंबर इज 3. इन द इन्फेंसी चैप्टर इट इज द थर्ड वीडियो. सो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट मिल्क. You all know that the children are taking only the breast milk, so the breast milk should have all the nutrients that he or she is needed. So according to the nutritional aspects, it is also very good. You know that it is the best according to the nutritional aspect. So the composition of the breast milk is correct for the infant. It is easily digestible and bioavailable. It can be easily absorbed by the baby's body. The main nutritional contributions are firstly on calories. Like it is giving the 65 kilocalorie energy per 100 ml. 65 kilocalorie per 100 ml. And which is enough for the infant, and the main sources of calorie is glycogen, glucose, fatty acids, etc. The carbohydrate calorie present is higher in the breast milk. That is very important, that is very much needed and desirable too. Okay, next the carbs. According to the carbs, human milk is sweet due to the presence of high amount of the lactose, because if it is not sweet, then the child wouldn't want to have it, right? It's because the children need, you know, like this sweet taste. So that is why it is sweet in taste, and also the lactose is very high, that is why it is sweet. And the lactose helps to absorption of the magnesium and the calcium that is needed for the bone health. Galactose present in the lactose, essential for the formation of the myelin. Myelin cell in his brain tissues, and which is in the protective covering of the nerve fibers. Okay, galactolipids present, and it is also help in the rapid brain development, because in this first stage the most brain development are happening, right? So in this stage the foods that we are giving that must develop the brain. And you know, the sugar is liked by your brain, and the brain loves to consume food to grow. So brain loves to love this carbohydrate to grow. So that is why the more amount of carbohydrate if you can give, then it will grow the brain properly. Next, the proteins. Protein is also needed for the development of their body, and 1.1 gram percentage that is needed, and it is present in the human milk. The protein is made up of 20% of the beta casein protein, as it is in milk the casein proteins are present, and 80% of the whey proteins. Okay, lactoalbumins are the amino acid pattern which body prevents from the essential it gives the essential amino acids, also help to prevent from the various diseases. The amino acids, glutamic acid maximum in this breast milk, but the glycine is absent. Due to the low protein content, the very little stress and the immature kidney can form to the infant, so we have to keep the proper amount. Then the taurine and the tryptophan and the many kind of this thyroxine, calcium, vitamin D also help to form and to digest these things. So many of the very important proteins are present here. Non-protein nitrogenous substances like the amino acids, peptides like nucleic acids are all present. Protein splitting enzymes like amylase, like of enzymes, are also present. Like this protein sources are also present, like protein splitting enzymes are also present. In this way, they can easily digest and lysis down these proteins, and can be assimilated and can be absorbed by their body, can work on their body. So everything is given in this breast milk. Next is lipid. Fat is also needed for forming their skin, the structure of their skin. The unsaturated fats, essential fatty acid, all the good fats are present, like EPA, DHA, which are important for the brain development, is also present. The carnitine is also present, which is very important for the oxidation. Okay, the PUFA and SFA, saturated fatty acid, and PUFA is SFA. Polyunsaturated fatty acid and saturated fatty acids is 1.2:1. That means the kufa is in a higher form, and it is also important, it is also needed and desirable. The fat content of the breast milk changes according to the satiety value of the infant. Okay, that how much the children is needed, that according to that it can be changed. And next, the minerals. Minerals consuming, I have already told you, the calcium and phosphorus is 1:2. And low sodium content does not create a load of the kidney, as the breast milk have low in sodium. And iron is also present, that is important for the blood formation, because a large amount of blood is needed because the size of the child is increasing. Now, the copper and zinc ratio is 1:5, because zinc is needed as the immunoglobulin functions. And the bioavailability of the copper, cobalt, iron, zinc, all are very high in the breast milk, that can be easily absorbable and that can be easily assimilable. So it is all about the minerals. Okay, next, the vitamins. All the vitamins are present accordingly. Vitamin C content is less, but still it is higher in this like a mature milk. Okay, the vitamin A, D, all are present, E, but they are less than the cow's milk, but it is good for the children. Okay, according to the need of the infant, it is producing in this breast. Okay, and some heat labile vitamin like B1, C is also available, because we don't have to heat, or we have don't have to sterile the breast milk, right? The children can have directly. So that is why the losses of vitamins are also very low. Next, the immunological aspects. What are the immunological aspects? That the breast milk can give some of the things that can give the children immunity. That is called the immunological aspects. What are the things are present? Macrophages are present, and both the T and B lymphocytes are present. Immunoglobulins or antibiotics are present. Immunoglobulins like G, A, M all are present. Lactoferrin is a very important part that can stop the E. coli functions, because E. coli can give rise to infections to the children body, and the lactoferrin help to control the E. coli. Vitamin B12 also have present, which helps in the growth of the microorganisms, good microorganisms. Lactobacillus bifidus factor, these are also helping to control these bad bacteria. Next, enzymes like lipase, oxidase, peroxidases also have their functions accordingly. And the lysozymes, which are present, which help to lysis down the bacteria which are present in their mouth. Next, the absence of the para-aminobenzoic acid or PABA prevents the growth of the material parasite, and which other parasites are usually presenting or happening or producing in the adult body. The immunoglobulin factors or the anti-factors are already present in the breast milk that can give the protection against them. Next, the endocrinal factors. Endocrinal factors means breast milk is rich source in the hormones like TSH, thyroxine, PTH, corticoids, and the like steroids like the calcitonin, oxytocin, insulin, prolactin, and many hormones. All are needed for the children. Physiological aspect, as the mother is feeding her child, they are forming one physiological aspect that it is also giving the good factor to the mother and as well a good to the children. Okay, and it can make a very good relationship between mother and her child. Next, the economical aspects. The mother's milk, we don't have to buy, we don't have to boil, and it is directly can be consumed. So we also can have to be prepared it, right? So the mother easily can make it in their body, and biologically it is forming, and the child can have. So for the first year of the age, the child don't have to take anything from the other. And if there is any economical problem, for the first year at least, the child can, or first 6 months at least, the child can have the best things from her mother. Nothing is have to buy from the outside, and it is a very important factor on the economical aspect. So other aspect and the jaw or teeth formation, like when the child is sucking the breast milk, the formation of the teeth and the jawline are became increasing, and the muscles are forming rapidly. Okay, incorrect formula is not coming, like the milk formula, if we take the like cow's milk and other any milk, and we can have to form like it is for related to this mother's milk, we have to relate it and then giving it to these children, then it can be wrong, right? So the formula can be wrong, but the mother's milk formula is very right. It is good for the children. Chances of colic wean are less. There's a if there the child is only consuming milk, there is a chances of forming gas in their body, but mother milk cannot form any gas. Okay, breastfed babies are believed in the better IQ. Who are breastfeeding, they have a better brain development and IQ as the EPA DHA are present in the breast milk. Always fresh and ready to drink, and it is renewable resource that can cannot be altered, and it is we should not have to dilute it, we should not have to boil it, just have to give to the children, it is the best. So these are the all aspects of the breast milk, and this is very important. The question usually come in a very regular purpose, like what are the advantages of the breast milk. The question also come like write the immunological aspects, write the nutritional aspects accordingly, and also can whole question like what are the nutritional aspects or what are the aspects of the breast milk, then you have to write the everything of it. Okay, I'll make a new video according to the mothers, what are the advantages of the mother to forming this breast milk or to giving this breast milk. Now I'm completing. Till then, thank you.